Hello students, myself Amrita Roy. Today we are going to discuss about the single phase AC circuit and resonance part 2. So let us go through the contents. We will see what is resonance and series resonance. So resonance in electrical circuit consists of passive and active elements that represents a particular state of the circuit when the current or voltage in the circuit is maximum or minimum with respect to the magnitude of excitation at a particular frequency, the circuit impedance being either minimum or maximum at unity power factor. The phenomenon of resonance is basically observed in both series and parallel AC circuits comprising of RLC and excited by an AC source. So, given is the diagram for a series resonance circuit. That is a series RLC circuit. We have here the passive components RL and C connected in with a series voltage source, AC voltage source. So in RLC circuit, we already know about some terms. So let us go through the terms properly. Inductive reactance, as we all know, is given by XL equals to omega L. So if we substitute omega with 2 pi F, it will give us the value of 2 pi F into L. Similarly, for capacitive reactance, we know that the term is denoted as XC equals to 1 by omega C, that is equals to 1 by 2 pi F into C. Now, when XL becomes greater than XL, the circuit is inductive. And when XC is greater than XL, the circuit is capacitive. So, the total circuit reactance XT is equals to XL minus XC if it has a high inductive value, or XC minus XL when it has a high capacitive value. And the total circuit impedance is represented as capital Z equals to root over of R square plus XT square. That is equals to R plus JX in rectangular form. Now, here is shown the graph for our series resonance frequency. Before that, we see under resonant condition, XL is basically equals to XC. So, if we substitute the values of XL and XC, we can find out the resonant frequency for the particular circuit. That is, if we substitute 2 pi FL and 1 by 2 pi FC by cross multiplying the values, we will get F square equals to 1 by 4 pi square LC. So, the actual resonant frequency is represented as F equals to 1 by 2 pi root over of LC. And in terms of omega, it is represented as 1 by root over of LC radian per second. Now, in the given graph, we can see that the y-axis is basically representing the reactance in ohms and the x-axis is representing the frequency. So, according to the relation of XL, we know XL is equals to 2 pi F into L. So, it is directly proportional to the frequency. So, as the value of frequency increases, so will the value of XL increase. So, we can see that for the graph of XL, it is increasing from origin to a high value. But for in case of XC, we know that the relation between XC and frequency is basically the opposite, because XC is equals to 1 by 2 pi F into C. So, as the value of frequency increases, so will the value of XC decrease and vice versa. So, when we are representing the value graph of XC, we will get a hyperbolic curve, because at zero frequency it will have the highest value, and at highest frequency XC will carry the lowest value. So by intersecting the two graphs of XC and XL, we will get a intersection point that which we will obtain the resonant frequency. So that resonant frequency will give the value of XL equals to XC, and before that, the in the graph, we will see that on the left hand side, the XC graph is basically having a higher magnitude compared to the XL graph. So, that part of the graph will behave in a capacitive manner. And on the right hand side of the resonant frequency, we will see that the right hand side of the graph has a basically a value of XL greater than XC. So, it will behave in an inductive manner. So, here we can see that the resonance frequency graph has three parts, that is XC greater than XL condition, XL equals to XC condition, and XL greater than XC condition. So in electrical resonance in AC circuits, when the two reactants are basically equal and opposite to each other, they will cancel out each other. Next is the impedance graph for the series resonance circuit. But before that, let us get accustomed with the definitions of dynamic impedance, admittance. So at resonance condition, the impedance of the series circuit is at its minimum value and equal only to the resistance R of the circuit. That is, the circuit impedance at resonance is called the dynamic impedance. If the circuit impedance is at its minimum and at resonance, the circuit admittance must be at its maximum. And one of the characteristics of a series resonance is that the admittance is very high. In a series resonance circuit, VL is equals to minus VC. So the resulting reactive voltages are zero and all the supply voltage is dropped across resistor. So in the given graph, we can see that the y-axis is basically representing the impedance and the x-axis is representing the frequency. So by adding up the values according to the previous slide, in that is as we obtained in the frequency graph, on the left hand side of the graph of the frequency range, we obtained that xc is greater than xl. So here we will get a hyperbolic curve decreasing from a high magnitude and tending towards zero, and on the right hand side of the graph we obtained xl greater than xc. So on the right hand side of the frequency graph, we obtained the magnitude slowly increasing. So in this way, by adding up the two graphs, we will obtain a resultant graph giving a almost parabolic type or parabolic format of the combined graph. So here also the left hand side of the resonant frequency graph is giving capacitive manner, and on the right hand side it is representing the inductive manner. So the point where it is basically intersecting is the point where we will obtain the value of impedance equals to resistance under resonance condition. So here that point is representing the dynamic impedance. Next one is the series RLC circuit at resonance condition. So we can see on the circuit diagram here, under normal condition, the LC tank is basically having voltage drops VL minus VC together. Now under resonance condition, the voltage drop becomes equal to zero. Why? Because as we discussed, under resonance condition, the voltage, that is VL, that is across the voltage drop across inductor and the voltage drop across capacitor will be equal and opposite. So it will cancel each other, and we know when a part of the line has no voltage drop, that part of the line will act as a short circuit. So here it is represented as XT equals to zero. That is, it is represented there is no reactance and it is behaving as a short circuit region. So that here we will represent it as a zero voltage drop, and at resonance the voltage drop basically is equal to zero on the reactance part. That is why when we are representing impedance Z equals to R plus JX under resonance condition, X will become equals to zero and we will obtain impedance equals to resistance. Now in the series circuit current at resonance, we are obtaining the maximum value of current at I equals to V by R. That is, when impedance is minimum, we will get maximum current. That is, we are here substituting the impedance with resistance under resonant condition. So here also we are obtaining the maximum value of current under minimum impedance or resistance. So the peak point is represented as Imax, and on the right hand side and left hand side of the graph, as we have seen in the previous slides, the left hand side is basically the capacitive nature of the circuit, and on the right hand side it is the inductive nature of the circuit. So on the left hand side of the graph, I will be equals to V by ZC. That is, the impedance is basically capacitive in nature, and on the right hand side of the graph the impedance is basically inductive in nature. So by combining all the graphs, we can see that it is basically similar to all the frequency related and impedance related graph. They are following the same nature, only we are substituting only we are seeing the parameters that how it will react when or how it will behave when it is behaving in the resonant frequency condition. Next one is the bandwidth of series resonance circuit. So let us get in accustomed with the few terms. That is, the frequency response of the circuit current magnitude relates to the sharpness of the resonance in a series resonance circuit. The sharpness of the peak measured quantitatively is called the quality factor capital Q of the circuit, and is given by Q equals to resonance frequency divided by the bandwidth. So at resonance, the power absorbed by the circuit must be at its maximum value, that is P equals to I square into Z. Now, if we reduce or increase the frequency until the average power absorbed by the resistor in the series circuit resonance is half of maximum value at resonance, we produce two frequency points called the half power points, that is the lower cutoff frequency and the higher cutoff frequency. Now, the distance between the lower and the higher cutoff frequency is basically called the bandwidth. Now, in the graph, we see that the bandwidth is represented as a distance between the two frequencies, that is FL and FH, and the point where it is basically intersecting is giving the two half power point frequencies. Now, the big value, that is I equals to V by R, is represented here by I max, and the point where the bandwidth is basically starting is given by a minus 3 decibel value at, that is 70% of the maximum current, that is at 0.707 I max value. So here the y-axis is basically representing the current and the x-axis is representing the frequency. Now, the bandwidth is basically the distance between the two half power point frequencies, that is the lower cutoff frequency and the higher cutoff frequency. So, for obtaining the bandwidth, we can use these two values, and the mid value of the bandwidth is basically actually the resonant frequency. So, we can obtain bandwidth by utilizing the two frequency values. Next one is the bandwidth of a series RLC resonance circuit. So here we see that it is being represented in three formats. The three graphs are being represented in different colors. The green portion is representing R with very small value. The blue violet portion is representing R with a medium value, and the blue portion is representing R with a very high value. Why it is representing with R with a high value? Because in the previous slide of impedance, we have seen that Z equals to R at that condition of the graph when we are obtaining the resonant frequency in the mid portion of the graph. So that portion is basically representing the high resistance value, and as we go on increasing that the value of the resistance, the graph will tend towards the mid point or the mid frequency. So now when we are decreasing the value of R, we will get the maximum value of current. That is why on the upper portion of the graph, as the resistance is becoming smaller and smaller, we will obtain the maximum value of current. That is, on the topmost point, the resistance will be very high, and on the lowest point of the graph, the resistance will be the highest, and on the highest point of the graph, the resistance will be the lowest. So actually, also like previous graphs, the left hand portion is basically representing the capacitive nature of the circuit, and the right hand side of the graph is representing the inductive nature of the circuit. Now, at omega R, ZT is minimum, and I max, IS is equals to maximum value. So we will get obtain a maximum value of current by V max divided by the impedance value. We will substitute the impedance value with the resistance and the reactances, giving us a value of V max by root over of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega RC square. Next one is the value of the cutoff, upper cutoff frequencies, and the bandwidth and quality factor. How we will calculate the values of these frequencies and bandwidth and quality factor? There, here are the derivation of the few terms. So at half power, Pm by 2, I equals to Im by root 2, that is 0.707 Im. Now Z equals to root over 2 of R, and X equals to minus R, that is, for capacitive nature, we will represent it, as minus R. So by substituting the values, we will get omega L equals to minus R by 2L plus root over of R by 2L square plus 1 by LC. And at upper cutoff frequency, the X will be equal to plus R. So we will represent as plus R by 2L plus root over of R by 2L whole square plus 1 by LC. Now for the bandwidth, we know that resonant frequency divided by quality factor, and it is given also by the higher frequency minus the lower frequency value, and in radians it is represented as R by L or R by 2 pi L hertz. Now the quality factor formula, it is basically represented as omega L by R or XL by R, that or 1 by omega CR, that is equals to XC by R, or at last as 1 by R into root over of L by C. So this is basically all about the series resonance. Next, in the next presentations, we will study about the parallel resonance circuits. Thank you.